Now I'm going to be giving an overview of the different scan methods available to generate 3D digital data. The two major scan methods I'd like to talk about are computed tomography and surface scanning. Computed tomography you may be familiar with from medical CT scanners, like the one you can see in the image on the left. Surface scanning, on the other hand, captures just the external morphology of an object. A third scan method you may have heard of is photogrammetry, where you take photographs of an object from many different angles and stitch them together. However, I'm not going to be covering this in this series because the methods used with photogrammetry are very different than the methods I will be showing you throughout this series. Surface scanning essentially works by using a laser to measure the morphology of an object. The raw data for this is a point cloud of the surface of the object that is then used to create the 3D digital representation. CT scanning, on the other hand, captures both the internal and external morphology of the object. A specimen is rotated, and at each rotation, an X-ray image is taken of the specimen. Or in the case of medical CT scanners, the X-ray camera rotates around the specimen. An example of this raw data can be seen on the right. You can see how, even though each of these slices only shows a single view of the object, when you combine all of them together, you can get a really good idea of the internal and external morphology of this rodent jaw. This raw data is then converted into a 3D volume, which is represented as a series of 2D slices through the object. An example of one of these slice stacks is shown here. You can see the slices are moving through the brain case, up into the nostril, and then you can start seeing some of the teeth in this rodent skull. Choosing a scan method depends on your available resources and the ultimate goals of this project. The biggest advantage CT scanning has over surface scanning is that it captures the internal morphology of the object. With a lot of fossils, rock matrix on top of the fossil makes CT scanning the preferable method so that you can see the internal details obscured by the rock. However, surface scanning does have some benefits over CT scanning. Surface scanning can be portable, while CT scanning is never portable. Surface scanning works well on much larger objects that wouldn't fit into even a medical CT scanner. And surface scanners tend to be cheaper than the very expensive CT scanners. All of these are things you will want to consider when deciding on the method that works best for you.